everyone, and welcome back to another video. So today I'm going to be talking about my Japanese literature TBR. So a couple of weeks ago I uploaded a video all about my Japanese literature recommendations, so my favorite books I've read so far from Japanese lit. And obviously everyone really likes hearing me talk about Japanese literature, and I feel like I never talk about the books that are on my physical TBR that I own, that I have not read, but also books that I just always have in, like, you know, I have on a bunch of wish lists that I want to get and read eventually. And recently I've just been in more of a Japanese literature kind of mood, so I figured making this video would kind of push me to getting and reading these books. So yeah, I have quite a decent list of books, but yeah, we're just gonna get right on into it and start with the books that I do have physically. So I currently have 4 books on my physical TBR. They're all short and then a giant one. So let's start with that giant one. I have Junji Chiro Tanizaki's The Makioka Sisters. I got this at a secondhand shop. When I saw it, I recognized it because this book is also in the collection of Japanese classics that were just distributed and repackaged by Vintage International. And I thought it sounded like a really interesting book. Plus, it was like the only book on that list of books that I hadn't read yet. Or I think there was one other that is on my TBR. So I decided to pick it up. I actually really love this, look of this book. I actually saw a couple of other of his books, but I decided to just get this one to see if I like it. Basically, this is about, I think, 3 or 4 sisters. Yeah, 4 sisters who have been raised in the traditions of aristocratic Japan and face the reality of the new post-war society. To be honest, let's just get real and throw it out that this reminds me of 3 Souls by Jenny Chang, because it's about sisters and after a post-world war climate. This is in Japan, 3 Souls is in China, but you know what I mean. I feel like this sounds like just a really awesome book. I love reading about women in Japan, especially in historical Japan, as well as I love reading about just kind of post-war, I guess, eras. So yeah, I decided to pick this one up. This is definitely the longest one, but I do have this on a TBR for November because Tome Topple is happening. So hopefully I'll be reading this very, very soon. And I very recently picked up these 3 little volumes of Japanese literature. If you follow me on Instagram, you saw me unbox all of these because I've been doing more Instagram stories. If you guys want to follow me on Instagram, again, I talk about books and do unboxings a lot on there. So there you go. So the first one I have is a book that I have had on my TBR and wishlist since before it was released. I had been anticipating this book and it came out, and it is so short. It is under 200 pages. And the hardcover was $25, and I just could not bring myself to buy that, and it hadn't gone down in price in ever since it got released. And then finally the paperback came out and it was a lot cheaper, so I decided to pick it up finally. And I get recommended this all the time, and that is The Convenience Store Woman by Sayaka Murata. Again, I feel like a lot of people know this one. I have had it on my TBR for so long. And this is about a woman who works at a convenience store, and she just kind of her day-to-day life. I feel like it's going to be a super quiet story. Oh, it's also about her finding a husband, there's a huge pressure for her to pursue a career and find a husband, but she doesn't feel like the need to do that. She just likes her simple life at the convenience store. And yeah, I don't know, that sounds really interesting to me. I love reading about women in Japan who kind of go against the social norm. And yeah, this is such a cute little volume. And again, it's only 200 pages, so I am so excited to pick this one up. The next book I have has been huge recently. I don't know what marketing this had or something, but it has been all over the place. I keep seeing people on BookTube haul this book that don't read Japanese literature, and I just have seen it everywhere. So I knew I had to pick it up. Plus, I had it specifically recommended to me by a couple of people. So I got Before the Coffee Gets Cold by Toshikazu Kawaguchi. And this is about a coffee shop where basically you can time travel or travel across dimensions or to different time periods and stuff, but you have to get back before the coffee that they give you gets cold. So, you know, only a couple of minutes. And I don't know, that sounds so interesting to me. And again, this is a very short little novel, just a little bit above 200 pages. And it sounds, I don't know, I love my quiet books. I love my day-to-day slice of life Japanese literature. It's some of my favorite, but my other favorite type of Japanese literature is the super weird, what the hell, that doesn't make any sense kind of Japanese literature, like Haruki Murakami. And I don't know, this sounds awesome. I think this will probably be the first one that I end up picking up, just because I am so excited for this one, and I feel like it could potentially be a favorite book of the year. So I will definitely be picking this one up in the month of November. And the last one I picked up physically is If Cats Disappeared from the World by Genki Kawamura. I have so many books on my list basically about cats. If you guys didn't know, watch my Japanese literature recommendations. But one of my favorite Japanese books of all time is I Am a Cat by Natsumi Soseki, which I feel like kicked off kind of the trend of cats in Japanese literature. And I haven't actually read really any since then specifically about like the cats. Like, I've always obviously read all of Haruki Murakami, so it, like, he has cats in it, but I haven't read like specifically about cats. And I'm not gonna lie, I don't super know what this one is about. It's about a young postman who is estranged from his family and living alone only with his cat Cabbage to keep him company. So I guess probably about loneliness and cats, and probably if his cat disappeared from the world, he'd be all alone, maybe, something like that. I love this cover. It looks so cute. I'd had this on my list for a while, and then when my friend specifically recommended this to me, I knew I had to pick it up. Also, this is like $6 on Amazon for the hardcover, so I had to steal that. So yeah, those are the books I currently have on my actual physical TBR. Now I'm gonna get into some books I might have as ebooks or just kind of like are on my mental TBR to pick up eventually. So the first one I have is The Housekeeper and the Professor by Yoko Agawa. This I do have as an ebook. This I think is the other book that was in that Japanese Vintage Classics edition that I haven't read yet, but I have been meaning to for ages, and I keep almost picking up a physical edition in like thrift stores and stuff, but I have the ebook. I should read it on ebook before I buy it just in case I don't like it. So I do want to pick this up very soon. It's a super short little volume. I absolutely loved her book Hotel Iris because I loved her writing style, so I know I'm gonna enjoy this. I feel like it's her most famous work. I don't know what this is about, if I'm completely honest, besides it being about a housekeeper. So I definitely want to get to this soon so that I can know what it's about, because again, it is a big Japanese literature book right now. Also by Yoko Agawa, I have her new book that just sounds amazing, and I'm eagerly waiting for it to go down in price, and that is The Memory Police. And again, I don't super know what this is about besides what the title tells us, and it looks awesome. And honestly, I saw this kind of like start getting talked about and advertised when I had read Recursion by Blake Crouch, which is also about memory and kind of like the like just memory and stuff. And so I immediately was like, oh my god, if this is anything like that, that's gonna be awesome. And yeah, I don't know that much about it besides the title. So I almost forgot, I actually have more books physically. Okay, so owning up to this time, I haven't read any of Murakami's short story collections except for Men Without Women. I own all of them. I haven't read any of these. I really don't like short story collections. I just am gonna say it. I never read them because when I do, I really don't like them. But I hear that Murakami's are some of like the best. Like, I brought up his name in my graduate class like a couple of days ago, and my professor was like, oh my god, I hear such amazing things about The Elephant Vanishes by him. And literally, I just need to read these. Like, I just need to, because I always say that I've read all of his books, which I've read all of his novels, but I haven't read his short stories. And I need to eventually. It's just, again, I love Murakami so, so much. I just don't want to read these and hate them because I really don't usually like short story collections, but I will eventually read these, I promise. The next book I have to talk about, I probably will save until next fall, probably next October, just because of the book, and that is Penance by Kane Minato, who is the person who wrote Confessions, which is like my favorite Japanese horror ever, which I also talk about in my Japanese literature recommendations. This, I'm assuming, is another horror book. Maybe it's not. Tell me if it's not, because then I can read it whenever, but I do like saving my horror books for October and then just reading all of them. But I loved Confessions so much that when I heard that she had another book, I knew I have to check it out. Not sure what this one is about. All I know is I love the author, so I have to check it out eventually. Oh, another book that I have on audiobook, not ebook, is The Traveling Cat Chronicles, another cat-related Japanese literature book, of course. This is one, again, don't super know what it's about, but I feel like I see it, like, all of my Instagram friends are constantly posting about this one and telling me to read it. So I checked, and I actually do have it on audiobook, so hopefully I will be reading this pretty soon. I feel like I've had this one on my TBR for so long, so I definitely want to try it out soon. Again, not totally sure what it's about. I also have Nono Boy by, I believe, John Osaka. I think I want to say that this is about Japanese America, or it might still be about Japan, but I think John Osaka is Japanese American. I'm not totally sure, but I feel like this is a book a lot of people read in school, if I'm like not mistaken, and I don't super know what it's about. I want to say it's about Japanese America, maybe Japanese internment camps, but I could be totally wrong. But I have had this one on my TBR, like mental TBR, for so long also. I feel like I see super mixed reviews, like either 5 stars or like 2 stars. So I'm really interested in this one. Again, I want to say it was like discussed in my Asian American literature class, and that's why I ended up putting it on my TBR, and then I saw a couple of people read it and like the reviews were all over the place, so I wasn't sure. But yeah, that one is very interesting to me. Definitely looking out for that one. Then I also have basically just anything by Ryu Murakami, but I specifically have In the Miso Soup on my wish list. This is one that a lot of people recommend me pretty consistently, but specifically Dylan has recommended me, and I know nothing about Ryu Murakami besides the fact that his last name is Murakami, so I always have to preface when I talk about Haruki that I'm talking about Haruki, not Ryu. But I have no clue what they're about. From the cover, it looks pretty explicit, which is very interesting in Japanese literature to me. So I have In the Miso Soup. I also have heard really good things about, I think it's called Piercing by him, and I've been pretty interested in him for a couple of years now. So I definitely want to give him a shot, if not by the end of 2019, then by early 2020 for sure. And then just a couple of authors just in general that I need to try more of. I really need to try more Yukio Mishima. I have tried, I think, 2 books by him, or maybe just one, that I just wasn't a huge fan of. So I honestly think I DNF'd them. Like, I don't think I finished them, so I never really talked about them. And I hear such amazing things about him, and he has so many books. So I do really want to give him another shot. I think I am interested in his book Confessions of a Mask. I want to say that's like his big book besides The Sailor Who Fell from Grace with the Sea, which I did try and didn't like. So if you guys have any Yukio Mishima recommendations, definitely tell me them, because I want to try him out, but I found his books that I tried just really, really boring and just really hard to get through, which is saying something because I like Natsumi Soseki, so I just found him really boring. I also feel like I should try more Yasunari Kawabata. I want to say I've read like 3 of their books, if I'm remembering correctly, and again, pretty boring to me, which, again, I feel like it's hard to bore me with Japanese lit, but I feel like I was pretty bored while reading their works. So that's another author I feel like I should just give another chance, just in case I was reading it at the wrong time in my life, so I just thought they were boring. And then I also have Banana Yoshimoto. I know, I have never read Banana Yoshimoto. I've heard amazing things about Kitchen and Ing, and I know my library has like all of her books, and I just need to try them out sometime. But yeah, I don't know. She's just never super interested me, I guess, because I have never really wanted to pick her up. Another book that I am pretty interested in checking out, again, probably next October, is a book that my friend Adele read this October, and it really, like, I was like, oh, I should have read that, and that is The Ring. I can't remember who it's by, but everyone knows what The Ring is. It's a Japanese horror book that's very, very famous, and again, I love my Japanese horror, so I definitely want to try out more, so I have that one too. And the last book that I have on my mental TBR is Twinkle Twinkle. I can't remember who this is by, but all I know is that I saw someone else get an Osasumi Books like box, because I also worked with Osasumi and I got really excited that someone else worked with them, and they hauled Twinkle Twinkle and said it's actually gay Japanese literature, which I have never read, and I really want to check it out. So I also have Twinkle Twinkle on this list. I want to say it's about two people who like kind of get into like just for convenience marriages, but then are actually together. So yeah, that sounds awesome. But anyways, those are all of the books that are currently on my Japanese literature TBR that I'm interested in. Definitely leave down in the comments below any more recommendations you have for me based on my reading tastes, preferably, and especially about those authors that I mentioned, because yeah, I am in a Japanese literature mood, so I definitely want to try to get to as many as I can. Anyways, I hope you guys all enjoyed this video, and I love y'all, and I'll see y'all soon. Bye!